Recording in progress.
Yes, yes. Good afternoon once again. It's Agui Alpha from Military Forex. And today's video, we're going to talk about Euro-USD. And I'll be explaining how I managed to take this trade, what projection that I'm going to focus concerning the next week movement, if this trade will hold or we will close for this week. And before I continue with that, let me take you to some few parts. Yes, and show you the previous view of this I shared to our Facebook page. This is the Military Trading Community Facebook page. And this was the trade I shared before. I think it was, let me annotate it so that you can see. Yes, it was December 6th at 7 a.m. I shared these setups, and this was what we were focusing on this trade. Let me clear the annotation. Yes, we were projecting this trade to come and test our previous highs, which failed to close above this short-term structure retest here. So I was expecting price to come, make a test here. If it failed to break above this level, we'll take a short trade with the continuation of the current trend till this lows here. So this was the setup shared before on our Facebook page. Also, this setup, a lot of explanation were given to our Telegram channel. Let me show you and how we. Okay, this was the setup shared to the community. We discussed it, we focused it. Where will EURUSD currently trend to? So, EURUSD, this was the four chart, and you are expecting to get an NFP news which failed to break the structure high at price still, and the price still ranging inside the structure high, though we managed to break the structure, but still no confirmation. Price may go up. Let's wait, more update will be out after Monday candle closure, and the Monday candle closure did this thing, as we can see here. Yes. Currently, we are at break even. We already take some partial profit because price managed to drop 800 pips for this move here. So what I'm not expecting for price to do is to come and close above here. If you get any candle closure above this high, that means we already invalidate this level. And we'll be expecting the price to range more highs because we managed to break the highs and failed to create a lower low on this price. But what I can see here is the formation of head and shoulder pattern. This right shoulder here, we have two bottoms. And I'm expecting also price to break this level and take out all these stop loss and break even around this level. Because why we're expecting that? Because this price, this highs here, failed to close below this low and also failed to come to make a test at this low here. That's why I'm projecting this price to take out a break even during this New York reversal London session. I mean, this New York reversal session, we're gonna retrace all the London movement that we managed to drop till this price level here. So let's wait for the price to react, and we'll react according to the price. And for how we managed to spot this is we plot the red line here. First, we do the top-down analysis. All the premium members understand how to do the top-down analysis. We look at monthly levels till we reach this level here where the current price is. So these were the previous highs and this was the previous low of this downtrend here. So this was the high, we managed to break this low, and this was the current 2 hour or 4 hour time frame trend. And if price could have managed to break this, then we will know that on EURUSD, we are currently hunting the upward movement. Concerning that price rejected this level and close below, then we break the structure here using the liquidity levels of supply and demand. We projected this multiple rejection. Price came to break these lows here. And as you can see during NFP news, it was Monday. I think it was, sorry, it was for this area here and this movement here, in which news played out before the outcome of the fundamentals, which we are waiting for the first Friday of new month. So for this case, price take out this buy stop here and take out their stop losses. Also come out and take the early break-even traders before we continue to drop. Now this drop here, give me confirmation that we may come and retest here, then to continue with the downtrend. Now for this downtrend here, as you can see, there are a low volume and low momentum on this movement. So I'll be ready to take out, I'll be ready to wait for the price to take me out for break-even trade and then break this level. I'll be waiting for a retest to continue with EURUSD bullish bias. That's what I'm waiting, but still my trade is at break-even. And if price came to take out our break-even, I'll be waiting for a lower time frame entry, re-entry if this momentum failed to close above. If these candles fail to close above, still I will manage to hold my buyers to short EURUSD. Currently, just focusing on DXY to wait for the DXY clear direction as projected on previous explanation video. Let me show you how. Yes, this is the DXY. Let's switch to 4 hour. Okay. DXY failed to close below this level. That means still in DXY you are in an uptrend movement. Now for that case, that means I'll be waiting for price to come and break these highs. I will still hold my EURUSD short trade till price managed to make a retest and continue with this uptrend. I'm targeting very, very long on this pair to reach a certain level so that I can close my short buyers on EURUSD. I think it is this high here. And for that case,
recording in progress.
And for that case, if I manage to break this high, I'll wait for the retest to continue to finish this movement here. That's how we do the top-down analysis. We forecast very high, and this will be our key levels to be monitored, and this one here. Same to EURUSD. We have our two levels, which we do not want to see the candle closure above or below. In which the candle closure above or below the structure will determine us where the price is heading to. So for today's, I think this will be the end of this video. Next video, I'll explain about NFP, the previous NFP news and what happened that I explained before on EURUSD, that price, the news came out but failed to take out this low or to close below this low, either to close above this size here. That means my short bars are still stronger than the long bars concerning Euro USD, though we failed to close below these highs here, which is our key level or point of interest concerning this price message here. Thanks a lot. Have a nice day. Wish you a happy weekend.